Cursor announced the release of GPT-5.2 Codex in Cursor, a new frontier model for long-running tasks. But that's actually not the main point of my video. Instead, the main point of my video here is about this post here by Michael Truell, the CEO of Cursor, where he mentions that they used this model, I assume at least, they're mentioning GPT-5.2 here, not Codex, but I guess he means Codex, that they used this model to build a browser with AI, with just AI, as I understand it, because it ran uninterrupted for 1 week. So the AI in Cursor ran for 1 week and built a browser. It wrote 3+ million lines of code across thousands of files, and the rendering engine it wrote was written from scratch, and it handles HTML parsing, CSS cascade, all the things you would expect from a browser, I assume. However, there then is one important restriction. It kind of works. And I totally get where the Cursor team is coming from here. It is impressive that just AI on its own wrote a browser that for the most part works. However, even though I never built a browser and probably never will, it's probably fair to say that it's all the parts that take it from 80 to 100% that are complex. And that's not just true for browsers. If you have built anything in your life, even outside of coding, you know that for most projects, the difficult part starts once you're 80% done. And I'm not even talking about the marketing and so on, which is super difficult. I'm talking about just building. And for many projects, for many software, you don't need to get to 100%, but 80% or 70% might not cut it. And it is that extra bit that can be super hard to achieve and where AI might not get you to. Just AI, I mean. And I want to be very clear here because it's easy to misinterpret or misunderstand that video. I am 100% positive on AI. I use it all the time. For example, buildmygraphic.com has most of its code written by AI. Not vibe-coded, though, instead with my instructions, with myself reviewing the code, with myself going into the code and tweaking stuff when it needs tweaking, but I used a lot of AI for this site. I also just released a huge update for my AI for Developers course, where I walk you through using GitHub Copilot and Cursor efficiently and explore the different features they offer to help you get more out of AI, because I believe, and I've shared that in other videos too, AI is the future for developers. It's a super useful tool, and using it heavily and efficiently will be vital. That is something I'm totally convinced of. I'm not so much convinced that vibe coding in its purest form will get us there. And that's probably worth explaining. Because there is a spectrum, I would say, between vibe coding and agentic engineering. Well, of course, you could also say there also is not using AI at all, but again, I'm convinced you should use AI. And the question is, where on that spectrum are you? Are you here? Are you here? Are you in the middle? And you can be anywhere there, but there are different trade-offs or use cases, I would say. The question also is how you define vibe coding. Vibe coding, as I understand it, is all about letting AI write the code, having no code reviews, having no understanding of the code base, and also passing no code-specific instructions like use this pattern or use this package. So really not knowing anything about the code. That's 100% vibe coding as I would define it. And there definitely are different other definitions out there as well. That's just what I mean with vibe coding. This form of coding does not have a future, in my opinion, for commercial products, for real products. It can be great, however, for other things, for other kinds of products. So vibe coding, for example, can be great, I would say, for personal utility tools or for throwaway software. So something which you use once or twice and don't care about too much, or maybe also for free software where you don't really charge people money and therefore it doesn't really matter if it works that well. You could make these arguments, and I would say these are use cases where pure vibe coding is viable. You can absolutely use AI to just request a script that does something, and you don't care if it covers all edge cases, if it maybe has some potential bugs, because if it gets the job done for you, you're happy. That is absolutely fine. And you can do vibe coding fine. Now, on the other hand of the spectrum, we have agentic engineering. And with agentic engineering, which is what I do and what I think is the future, you use AI as a tool. This does not mean that you use it just for the dumb tasks that can include complex tasks. Very important to me, because it's easy to get this wrong, but this can include complex tasks. But it means that you have clear instructions regarding patterns, libraries, etc. you want to use. It also means that you do review the code in one way or the other, can also include automated reviews with help of other AI tools, but you will look at the code from time to time to understand what's going on. And it also means that you get into the code yourself when the AI gets stuck or when you want to get it started with a certain implementation where you know how a certain interface or should look like or which pattern you want to use, so that the AI can then finish your thoughts, so to say. I would say this is the future this year, agentic engineering. That is my future, at least. And of course, I could be wrong here. Maybe in a couple of years, vibe coding is the only way because the AI is so good that it can do everything. I don't think it will, but it absolutely could. I think the only wrong decision right now, however, is to not be anywhere on this spectrum. You should be anywhere here. You should definitely use AI, and I've shared that in other videos. However, coming back to this post, I have a problem with that kind of works thing. And I understand it as mentioned here in the context of this cursor post. It's also worth noting that clearly the cursor team kind of wants to shift the narrative or maybe gain more visibility again, especially on X, where the past weeks have been dominated by developers using Claude code with the Rolf loop to let AI build everything in the end in a vibe coding inspired way. It makes sense that the cursor team wants to show that you can use cursor too to do long running tasks with AI and let AI build software autonomously, because that clearly is something that's gaining a lot of visibility right now, especially on X. So I totally get this. And again, cursor is an amazing tool. I want to be very clear regarding that. I just have a problem with this kind of works attitude because I think it's accelerating. It's becoming more and more a thing now with AI. And we've seen it for years. We've seen it long before AI, that operating systems like iOS or Windows got worse. They're full of bugs. You can see it in video games, which are often unplayable on day one. You can see it in so much software. It has nothing to do with AI. Software quality got worse. And I get it. We can iterate quickly. You can patch things up. That's kind of the mindset that developed over the last 15 years or so. And that is the mindset I see continuing and accelerating now with AI. Because with AI, you can patch things up quickly, of course. And if you are vibe coding, for example, then you might not care too much about bugs because you can fix them in an instant anyways. And having a horrible code quality in your code base might not matter because no human needs to get in there. The AI can figure it out and fix it. And if your fix is a bunch of if statements to fix all the different things that could go wrong instead of one clean implementation, that might not matter. And again, that is absolutely one future we could have. I don't think it's the future. I certainly don't hope it's the future, but we could have that as a future. But I also think that as developers, as companies building software, there will be a real market for high quality software. Software that's not broken on day one. Software that's not shitty. And you could use AI to build better software too. There is no law that forces you to move quick and sacrifice software quality. You can use AI to build better software, to get the best out of both worlds, to combine your skills with AI, to use AI as an extra pair of eyes to look over your code. And I would hope that we kind of go more into that direction, because I believe that whilst the majority probably won't, valuable opportunities will open up for companies and developers that do build high quality software and that do try to get the best out of both worlds.